Magandang araw. Sa videong ito, atin pong tatalakayin ang division of polynomials. Okay, so at the end of the video, you are expected to divide polynomials using the long method. Ngunit bago yan, ito muna.
Welcome to Mala.
Legendary! 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 Legendary!
Okay, so atin nang talakayin ang division of polynomials. And let's consider one example to understand more kung paano ba nagdi-divide ng polynomials. Okay, so we have here divisor or dividend and a divisor. So the first thing that you're gonna consider when dividing polynomials is the dividend should be in standard form. Okay, so napag-aralan naman na natin sa nakaraang video kung paano magsulat ng isang polynomial sa standard form. So, we don't have any problem relative to that since, yun nga, napag-aralan naman na natin dun sa nakaraang video. So, the only thing that you have to consider also is kung meron bang nawawalang exponent. I mean, if it is in, gaya nito, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0, yung mga exponent, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0. Okay, wala naman. So, kompleto naman. So, magkakasunod naman papababa. But there are instances kasi kapag yung exponent mo ay 5, 5, 3, 1, 0. Okay, so wala yung number 4. Okay, wala rin yung 2 na exponent. So, if that would be the case, ang ilalagay mo kapag would be 5, 0, 3, 1, 0. Yung magiging ayos ng ating polynomial. So, since nasa standard form naman at magkakasunod nga talaga yung mga exponents, walang nawawalang numero, then we can proceed with the division process directly. Okay, so kailangan na nating isulat yung ating given as if we are dividing whole numbers. Okay, so let's now divide. Okay, so kapag nagdi-divide kang, ikukonsidera mo lang ay yung isang term muna. Okay, pero as well as, okay, this would be your dividend kapag yung nagdi-divide na isa-isa. As well as, ito naman yung divisor mo. Okay? So, we have x raised to 4 divided by x. Okay? Magkaparehong variable nagdi-divide, subtract the exponent. Okay? So, we have x. 4 minus 1, that is 3. Okay? Ngunit, kapag nag-multiply ka na, ito nang gagamitin natin. Itong dalawang ito. Okay? So, let's now have the multiplication process. X raised to 3 times x. Okay? So, that is x raised to 4. Okay, then x cubed times 2. That is 2x cubed. Okay, then subtract. Okay, so syempre, 3x cubed minus 2x cubed. That is x cubed. Okay, then 0 naman na ito. Then bring down one term. Okay, parang nagdi-divide ka ng whole numbers na kapag pagkatapos mong mag-subtract, nag-bring down din tayo ng isang digit. Okay, so in this case, isang term naman yung i-bring down natin. Okay, next, x cubed divided by x, that is x squared. Okay, x squared times x, that is x cubed. Next, x squared times 2, that is, okay, plus 2x squared. Okay, so let's now have the subtraction process. Okay, so, negative 4x minus 2x squared. Oh, negative 4x squared minus 2x squared. Okay. So, we have. Okay. So, medyo nakakalito. But, just apply yung division of or subtraction of integers natin. So, change the sign of the subtract. So, this becomes negative. This becomes negative. Then, proceed sa addition. Okay, so negative 4x squared plus negative 2x squared, that is negative 6x squared. Then, 0 naman na yan. Then, bring down negative x. Negative 6x squared divided by x, that is negative 6x. Negative 6x divided by x, times x. Negative 6x times x, That is negative 6x squared. Negative 6x times 2. That is negative 12x. Okay, then subtract. So this becomes positive. This becomes positive. Okay, so that is, then proceed sa addition. So negative 6x plus 12x, that is 11x. Okay, then 0 naman na ito. Then bring down 1. Okay, 11x divided by x, that is 11. 11 times x, 11x. 11 times 2, that is 22. Then subtract. Okay, so this becomes negative. This becomes negative. Okay, so we have, okay, proceed sa addition. 1 plus negative 22, that is negative 21. Okay, so in this case, ang quotient natin ay ito. Okay, so that is x cubed plus x squared minus 6x plus 11. Okay, ang remainder naman natin ay ito na. So negative 21. Let's consider the second example. We have 2x squared plus x cubed plus 1 divided by the quantity x minus 1. Okay, so sabi natin, kailangan nating isulat in standard form. Okay, kasi nga, okay, kung mapapansin natin, nauna yung 2 followed by 3. And kapag standard form, dapat papababa yung ating exponent. Okay, so we have x cubed plus 2x squared plus 1. Okay. Ngunit, kung mapapansin natin, merong nawawalang exponent. Okay. Wala yung linear term natin. Okay. So, we have 3, 2, okay, tsaka 0 na agad. Okay. So, kung mapapansin natin, wala yung 1. Okay. So, if that would be the case, ang magiging itsura niya kapag would be x cubed, okay, plus 2x squared. Then, nasaan yung exponent na 1? Okay, so that would be 0x raised to 1. Or since 1 naman na ito, kahit huwag munang ilagay. Then, plus 1. So, this would be our dividend. Okay, yan yung sinasabi natin kanina. Na kapag wala, merong nawawalang term, hindi tayo pwedeng mag-divide agad-agad. Okay, kailangan muna natin i-considera na 0x. So we have now x cubed plus 2x squared plus 0x plus 1 divided by x minus 1. Okay, so x cubed divided by x, that is x squared. X squared times x, that is x cubed. Then x squared times negative 1, negative x squared. Then minus. Okay, so this becomes negative, this becomes positive, then proceed sa addition. Okay, so 2x squared plus x squared, that is 3x squared plus 0x. Bring down natin yung isang term. 3x squared divided by x, that is 3x. 3x times x, that is 3x squared. 3x times negative 1, that is negative 3x, then minus. Okay, so this becomes negative, this becomes positive. Okay, then proceed sa addition. 0x plus 3x, that is 3x. Bring down 1. Okay, next. 3x divided by x, that is, okay, 3. 3 times x, that is 3x. Okay, then 3 times negative 1, negative 3. Then subtract. Okay, so this becomes negative, this becomes positive. Then proceed sa addition. Okay, so we have 1 plus 3, that is 4. Therefore, ang ating quotient ay, ito na, x raised to 2 plus 3x plus 3. Okay? Then, ang ating remainder ay 4. Okay? Kapag sagot naman ang hinahanap sa inyo, that would be yung quotient. So, that would be x raised to 2 plus 3x plus 3, okay? Then, ano yung sign ng remainder natin? 4. Okay, so that is plus 4 over the divisor. So that is x minus 1. So that is how you're gonna write your answer. So in general form, yung answer mo dapat ay quotient, okay, plus, okay, yung remainder over the divisor. Okay, so sana nasundan ninyo yung pagdi-divide ng polynomials.